Welcome back to YouTube online classes for BSc first semester in zoology subject. So last class we have already discussed about the phylum Nemanthelenensis. So we have already finished that the general characteristics of Nemanthelenensis or Ascalenensis. So today we have to discuss about the continuation part of the phylum Nemanthelenensis, that is classification of Nemanthelenensis. So you know already the classification. So this Nemanthelenensis is having the special characteristics. So that's why it's called as super phylum. This super phylum is divided into five phyla. So one is Rotifera, and second one Gastrotheca, and third one Chironica, fourth one Nematomorpha, and last Nematoda. So these are the five phylums are divided in a super phylum, that is Nemanthelenensis or Ascalenensis. So why we are saying this as a super class? Because it is having a main special theme, that is organ level of organization. So organ level of organization is nothing but the body is having the organs. So that's why we have to consider it as a super phylum. So this super phylum is divided into five super phylums. One is Rotifera, Gastrotheca, Chironica, Nematomorpha, and Nematoda. So this Nematoda is the living species and it is very very important for the classification. So now we should understand the general characteristics of Rotifera. So what are the meaning of Rotifera and what are the phyla including animals? So that one we have to understand today. So first one is Rotifera. So phylum Rotifera is a microscopic animal. It is microscopic animal and found in lake, ponds, streams and rarely in oceans. So this is the main characters of phylum Rotifera. So that this is microscopic animal and it is found in lake, pond, streams and mainly in the oceans. So the next character of the Rotifera is body wall is thickened into stiff plates. So stiff plates is nothing but the body wall. If the body is like this, the body is having stiff plates on the body wall. So scale-like structures are found on the body, that is called as stiff plates are found on the body of Rotifera. The next thing, the anterior end with ciliary disc and used for feeding and locomotion. So anterior, this is the anterior portion of the animal and this is the posterior part of the animal. So this anterior part of the animal is including ciliary disc is nothing but this is helpful to find out food and the feeding process is nothing but they have to consume the food by the help of ciliary disc or corona. So these are the parts are found in the anterior part of the body. So that is another characteristics of Rotifera. The next one is, in the posterior part of the animal, there is an anal unit or tail is present. So tail is present here. The ciliary disc are present in the posterior part of the animal and the anterior part is having the anal or anus or tail is present in the posterior part of the body. The next one is digestive system with grinding organ mastac. So digestive system is present, but it is having a grinding is nothing but they have to break down the food in the particles. That is called as grinding organs are present as well as mastac. So this is also one of the organ which is present in the anterior part of the body, in the ciliary disc. So the digestive system is present and including the grinding organ as well as mastac. The next is excretory system of photonephridia and two photonephridial tubes are present. Means excretory system is nothing but removing waste from the body. So that organs are present and those are protonephridia and photonephridial tubes. So these are the excretory organs which are present in the rotifera phylum. The next is nervous system, three major glands. Means nervous system is also present and it is three pairs of ganglia and nerves. Ganglia, nerves. Means digestive system is also present, excretory system is also present, as well as nervous system is also present in the rotifera. But nervous system including three pairs of ganglion nerves which are present in the brain system of rotifera. The next is sensory organs are antennae and eye spots are present. Antennae is nothing but these are the antennas. So the sensory organs are antennae and as well as eye spots are present in these animals. Then next, male is smaller than female. So always male is smaller than female. So male is always smaller than female. Then next, no larval stage of animals. No larval stage. So male is always smaller than female as well as no larval stage. It is direct development in the animal of rotifera. So which is the example of rotifera? So example is Pilodina as well as Rotalia. So these are some characteristics of rotifera. So first is, these are microscopic animals and found in lake, stream, ponds and especially in the oceans. After that, the body wall is having the stiff plates and the interior part of the body is including feeding organs and the posterior part of the body is including canal or tail. And the digestive system is having a grinding tube, grinding organs, and as well as mastac is a special organ present in the digestive system. And excretory system is also present and it is including protonephridia and photonephridia tubes. And next is nervous system is including three pairs of ganglion nerves are present and sensory organs are antennae and eye spots. Last is, there is no larval stage in the rotifera. So these are some characteristics of phylum rotifera. And example are Philodina and Rotaria. Then next one is the next phylum, that is Gastrotheca. Next phylum of super phylum Nemandelementis or Astelementis, that is the second one is Gastrotheca. Phylum Gastrotheca. So this Gastrotheca is also microscopic animal. You know already, these all are microscopic animals. So Gastrotheca is also microscopic and it is found in marine as well as freshwater. It is found in both the part of the water bodies, that is marine as well as freshwater. fresh water. But in the rotifera, those are microscopic as well as they are found in oceans. Means they are also marine animals. But here in the gastrotrichia, these are microscopic as well as marine and freshwater animals. The next one is body wall with small cuticle. So, body wall with small cuticle. But in a rotifera, those are having stiff plates are present in the rotifera. But in a gastrotrichia, the body wall is having a thick cuticle and short curved dorsal spines. Short curved dorsal spines are present on the body of gastrotrichia. But in a rotifera, those are like this. Plates like stiff plates are present on the body of rotifera. But in the gastrotrichia, those are thick cuticle is present and small curved spines are present on the body wall. The next one is the corona is absent. In that, the digestive organs means the interior part is having the corona or ciliary disc. But in these, there is a no corona as well as no ciliary disc are present in these animals, and as well as ventral surface for locomotion. Cilia is the locomotion part. Cilia is the locomotory organ. In that, antenna as well as the body strips are present on the body wall. Those are the locomotory organs. But in these, cilia is the locomotory organ is present in the gastrotrichia, and mouth is surrounded by bristles. Mouth is surrounded by bristles and as well as pharynx. So mouth is surrounded by bristles and pharynx. And another one is excretory system with two fruton epithelia. There also excretory systems are present in the rotifera. Here also excretory systems are present. And nervous system with saddle shaped ganglion and two lateral nerves. Nervous system with saddle shaped ganglion and two lateral nerves. Those in the rotifera, those are three pairs of ganglion nerves are present. Here, nervous system is saddle shaped ganglion. Saddle shaped is nothing but they are like these nerves. Saddle shaped nerves are present as well as two lateral nerves. Two lateral means there is a branch like structure like this. So, the saddle shaped ganglion is also present and two pairs of lateral nerves are present in this nervous system. So, the digestive system is no corona and there is a locomotory organ is cilia, but the nervous system with saddle shaped and ganglion and two lateral nerves are present in this animals. The next is, these are monoecious or dioecious. You know dioecious and monoecious meaning. These are monoecious or dioecious. Dioecious. The next character of gastrotrichia, there is a development is direct. Development is direct. So development is direct in this animal. So example of gastrotrichia is Chitonus. Or Macrodysis. So these are the some characteristics of phylum Gastrotrichia. So these are microscopic. These are present in marine as well as fresh water. And the body wall is a thick body wall, thick cuticle. And this thick cuticle is having the spiral of spines on the body wall. The next is the interior part of the body. In the mouth part is having the pharynx and bristles are present in these animals. And the digestive system is having no corona, no ciliary disc are present in these animals. And cilia is the locomotory organ in gastrotica. And nervous system with saddle-shaped ganglion and two lateral nerves are present. And these are dioecious or monoecious. And development is direct. And the example is ketamatous and marodiasis. So these are the examples of gastrotica. So in the next period we will continue the other three phylums of Nemanthelamentis or Ascalamentis. Thank you.